guys, thanks for joining me here today. I know we've been talking a lot about SCTE messaging, SCTE, how that applies to the industry, how that applies to video, and especially in the streaming OTT space. Let's start by answering the question, what is SCTE 35 messaging and SCTE 104?
SCTE 35 messaging is the messaging that's transmitted in-band along with the transfer stream that describes the transfer streams in terms of where particular segments in the content start and stop in terms of presentation timestamps sort of PCR timestamps that go along with the transfer stream. The first use of SCTE 35 and historically what they were for was to mark up local availability for local ad insertion. So if you're a network, you're transmitting your content over the satellite, you want your affiliates to be able to insert their local advertising at certain points in the broadcast. And SCTE 35 was first used for this to signal these points where a local station could put their advertising in.
That sounds a lot like Q-tones, DTMF tones.
Exactly. That was a replacement for Q-tones, DTMF tones, and actually the first SCTE 35 syntax actually had facilities to sort of represent legacy systems where you could say that, okay, I'm gonna do this DTMF combination of the SCTE 35 message, and then the receiver on the other end would actually produce that sequence on one of the audio channels.
Okay, so I'm gonna ask you, Alan. Sorry, you've obviously been around companies that originate a lot of channels.
Mm-hmm.
DTMF has been around since the 70s. In your experience, are people still using DTMF tones, or is it all SCTE 35 messaging now? A little bit of mix. What can you say about that?
Oh no, there's a large, well, maybe not large. There's a significant number of cable head ends out there still that are probably still using legacy DTMF tones. And in fact, the SCTE 35 standard still has the DTMF descriptor in it for that purpose, and it won't be removed until, you know, we're absolutely sure that everything's gone to maintain backward compatibility. I mean, the pre-roll spec in SCTE was designed originally for allowing the tape machine to spin up so that it was ready to roll when, you know, the switch occurred. But of course, you know, in the modern day, it's going to be used to allow database lookups to take place for someone to decide what ad to play.
I guess that's where the term Q-tone comes from.
Exactly,
is to cue up the tape.
Exactly so.
But I've heard, Larry, I don't know if you've heard, but I've heard that companies today in the digital world are asking for longer pre-roll times, quote unquote, because they're not queuing tapes anymore, but like you said, they have database lookups and...
Absolutely, they have to get data from a number of different places. And really, the reason why the embedded metadata has become so important is that we have to put more data into the vertical blank than we could with DTMF tones. DTMF really was really a very small chunk of data. And now a lot more data can be encapsulated using 104 and 35s.
So what kind of data are you seeing that our customers are asking for?
Well, I mean, really, it goes down to the same initial concept, which was we need to mark breaks. Mm-hmm. But now it's becoming more granular, and we're making a distinction between local breaks and national breaks. And they're including information about, you know, what's actually the content within that break. And then, of course, on top of that, we have to mark program segments. Chapter starts, program starts, chapter ends, program ends.
We're going to get into why in a little bit.
Okay.